Hey guys, so just as we had with Legends Festival last year and the year before, we do have these rewards for every crystal we spent basically up until this point in time right here from last year's Legends Festival. So from last year's Legends Festival, it's the same pretty much format. It's every 1,000 crystals you've spent, you get a gold plate. So this is what they're calling the Supreme Thanks Campaign. Legends Festival Celebration, Supreme Thanks Campaign. From the bottom of our hearts, we thank you for always playing and enjoying Legends. Get one festival plate, 2022 gold for every 1,000 chrono crystals used between November 1st, 2021 and November 1st, 2022. So the one thing I do want to clarify here is that specifically in the past two Legends festivals, they have specified that it's chrono crystals used on summons. This one does not say just summons, so it's possible that they've expanded the crystals used to things like energy refills, equipment rerolls, stuff like that, that is not just summons, because I've definitely used a lot of crystals rerolling equipment. So I would love for those to actually count towards how many gold plates I'm receiving. And then once you've received those gold plates, you can take a look at the shop, which we will in a second, and use those to exchange for things such as Legends Limited Z Power, summon tickets, PvP messages, and so on. So this, again, covers the period of November 1st last year to November 1st of this year. So I've pulled up the banners that correspond to the beginning and end of this period of time. So if we go over to DBZ Space, we can see that the first banner, I believe this is the first big time banners that released post the calculation period. So we have the Legends Festival banners from Legends Festival banners from last year, the Legends Festival Step Up Call of Hope featuring Sword of Hope Trunks, and of course we have Legends Festival Step Up Beyond the Trust with the Tag Goku and Vegeta from last year. They both came out on November 24th, and those I think were the first banners to calculate or to count towards the calculation period of these gold plates. And then the final banner that they're counting is going to be the Superhero Step Up banner featuring Beast Gohan, still up by the way, but this one came out on December 19th, so before the end of the calculation period. So I think this is the period of time they're calculating from. So from these banners being out until the Beast Gohan reveal and release. So that's really what we're looking at here. Let's take a quick look and see what the exchange shop actually looks like. Last year, I remember it being pretty good. They had a lot of stuff in there. So this time, if we go here, we have a bunch of stuff. So I already have 83 of these silver plates. I actually don't know what that's from. I don't know why I just have 83 of those, but sure. It looks like we can pick up some gold plates anyway by exchanging those. But you can get Legends Limited Z Power. You can get these summon tickets. You can get different sleeves from the title screen characters. You can get PvP messages. And it looks like you can get souls here. So you exchange, it looks like it's 4 plates per 1,000 Zenkai soul. I imagine there's super souls and rising souls in here as well, yeah. And then other just has a bunch of resources. We have Zenny, we have gold bells, slot removers, platinum coins, energy, skip tickets, equipment medals, and rare medals. Would have been nice for them to put in those fragment medals and maybe some soul medals as well, but this is still pretty good. So let me just see. So this is 30 gold medals. You can get up to 300 slot removers. You can get up to 20 platinum coins, which is actually pretty good. Up to 1,000 energy, 500 skip tickets. What is this? 15,000 equipment medals. Okay. And then this is looks like it's 10,000 rare medals. Okay. And then once you've gotten those, I mean, you just pick up like any of these accessories that you want, sort of like the aesthetically pleasing things, whether it's sleeves or PvP messages, whatever, Legends of Z Power. And then of course, every gold plate you can use to exchange for one summon ticket. And then they also have the souls as well that we just looked at. So with that said, we're gonna take a look and see how many of the gold plates I received. So for me, I took a look and I went to go see how many I received last year. So last year, I received 5,325 gold plates. I do not think that I am going to eclipse last year's number, not even close. And the main reason why I don't think we're gonna eclipse that is because they started making every single banner have double rates and double Z power from last year's Legends Festival. On top of the fact that the gold plates that I received from last year's Legends Festival, a lot of those banners that I summoned on didn't even have the summon coin feature. That wasn't out yet at the point when I received those gold plates. So I definitely expect, if I received 5,325 gold plates last year from the summons that I did, my guess as to how many gold plates I received this year is probably less than 4,000. I'm probably expecting somewhere in the 3,000 range. 3,500, 3,700, 3,300, something like that. That's my guess. And again, based off of the wording, it sounds like they are counting the non-summon Chrono Crystal usage as well. So that's going to be good as well. All right, so without further ado, let's go ahead and open up the gift box and we will see what the count looks like. Again, my guess, somewhere in the 3,000s. I'm going to say between 3,200 and 3,700 would be my guess, but I could be completely wrong, and let's go ahead and see here. What do we have? Actually, it's a little lower than I thought. Okay, so bait a little under 3,000, 2,962. That should tell you how big of a difference this game has, I guess, created in terms of how much easier it is to actually get characters now, in terms of summons. So again, last year, so basically I'm talking about the period from end of the year 2020 to end of the year 2021, that 1 year period, 5,325 gold plates for that 1 year period. Now we're below 3,000. So basically, what's the difference? I'm gonna calculate the actual difference here. So 5,325 minus the 2,962. So I received 2,363 less gold plates this year as I did last year, while still basically maxing everything out. Like nothing, that there wasn't that big of a change in like how many characters I maxed out last year compared to this year. I only have six characters in the game that are not fully maxed out, but they're like EXs that recently released, and I usually don't really care about those anyway. So that just goes to show you, with the 2x sparking rates, the 2x Z power, and the summon coin mechanic being implemented into the game, that is a really, really significant difference. And I would even say as well that we probably received more banners this year than last year. So that is a pretty significant difference. So that's actually pretty interesting to think about. And it definitely does make me happier. I did not want to receive 5,000 gold plates again. That would have been pretty annoying to see. Okay, but now with the gold plates in tow, let's go ahead and head back over here. So I think what I want to do is just buy every single one of these aesthetic things here. We'll do this. This might take a while just because there's so much in here, but I want you guys to let me know down below, did you expect me to get more gold plates than I did? Or do you think that, again, based off of how they've handled summons, with all the changes they've made with summon coins and double Z power, do you think that that seems about right? I definitely think that I thought I was going to get a little bit more than that, but sub 3,000 is pretty good. I will definitely take that. I also want you guys to let me know down below how many you received as part of Legends Festival. Did you receive more than you thought, less than you thought? Definitely be interested in hearing what you guys have to say. But okay, that's all the sleeves and PvP messages. I guess now you actually can exchange the silver ones for Zenny, huh? Okay. I might actually do that, but let me just buy all these first. I mean, I pretty much have infinite gold plates. Like, I'm never gonna run out of gold plates, so might as well just buy all this stuff here. Yeah, let's just do this. Let's just buy all these. I'm gonna be capped at 10 here, so I gotta exchange later. Let's do that. I'm actually not gonna buy the energy just yet, just because I'm capped on energy and my entire gift box is just filled to the brim with energy. So I feel like it's not worth buying that yet. This is really good. Look at all these equipment medals we're getting here. And then the rare medals we'll pick up as well. But yeah, in case you guys didn't know, here's what my gift box looks like. I saw one of the comments in one of my recent videos been like, show us your gift box. Okay, you guys wanna see my gift box? Here you go. This is my gift box. It's 170 unaccepted gifts. This is pretty much what it is. We have this. I guess I should use this, huh? Didn't even remember this was in here. Okay. Yeah, I'll definitely. I'm actually glad I checked now. Glad I checked my gift box. But this is 98% of this gift box's energy. We have a platinum coin in there. But yeah, just because I I was capped at energy until today when I farmed the game exclusive unique equipment. But yeah, there we go. That's pretty much what I wanted to cover in this video here. We have the gold plates that are out. Make sure you guys definitely take advantage of the gold plates. It's literally just free stuff. Go into your gift box, accept these, and then use them to stock up on any resources that you might need. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all in the next one.